Hi, everybody. It's Gene Simmons, and you're not, and you're listening to the Potter Than Hell podcast with Steve, BC, BB, and Dylan. But you knew that, didn't you?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Potter Than Hell podcast. This is your last stop on the crazy train of hard rock and heavy metal. So sit back, buckle in, and hang on. Here we go.
Hello, Potter Than Hellions. Welcome back to the Potter Than Hell podcast. This is Steve, your host. I have a whole fucking gang here tonight.
The KISS Clan.
That's right. We'll go around the table. We're not even going to introduce the regulars first. Across from me, we got Rob.
Hey, how's it going?
It is good. Scott.
Hey, everybody.
BB.
Yo, Potter Than Hellions, what's up?
Mr. Granza, Chris Granza. How are you, my friend?
I'm good, thank you.
Good. Okay. Look at him. He's so soft-spoken, isn't he? And myself, of course. And we got Dylan on the keyboard.
Dylan.
Although, this is not, as you guys see by the title, we're doing the Perfect KISS album part two. And we're not going in order like the KISS albums did. The first one we did the first three KISS albums. But I decided to shake it up. But I did divide them into three. But this one is like three and a fourth, maybe, because we're doing Creatures.
Three and a third.
We're doing Creatures, Lick It Up, and Animalize. But we're also doing, including the four songs from Killers as well. So a couple extra songs in that one, too. So
it's a little makeup, non-makeup going on here.
Yeah, for sure. So we'll get into that in a little bit. But first of all, I hope you guys enjoyed last week's episode. We did part four of our Rush saga with Mark Anthony Kay. Awesome having Mark here. Always great talking with him about Rush and, you know, Project Gemini for him. And I was thinking about it too. And when this stupid guy come up to me when we went to see Rush in Philadelphia, me and Dylan, I had a KISS shirt on. This guy's like, hey, did you wear your KISS shirt because Rush opened up for a KISS and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, no, I just wore a KISS shirt.
What if that guy's listening?
Huh?
You just alienated a listener.
No.
What if that guy is listening?
He's
what
not.
If he is a fan of yours?
He's not.
All of a sudden, you're down one.
He's not.
You're down
he's
one.
He's not.
Buddy.
He's not.
1,999.
Who fucking invited you?
You did. I got the text to prove it here.
True.
Authority.
Anyway, but like, so Rush was our opening act for us last week, so we got KISS.
That's what I was getting together.
And if you're that guy out there, I apologize to you. You caught me at a bad thing. We had a flat tire on the way down. We actually did.
Yeah. That explains it.
Yeah, that's kind of sucked. God, I totally lost my train of thought now. All right, so before we get into KISS, AC/DC has released a new album. Another band that opened up for KISS as well. They put a new album out, Power Up, out 2 weeks when you guys hear this one, and I just wanted to see if anybody here checked it out. Dylan, have you checked it out?
I did. I had forgotten it was coming out, and then I saw that I was like, oh, okay, cool. I checked it out. It's okay. I like some of the tracks on it. I think Demon Fire was one that stuck out to me. I like the faster-paced songs. There wasn't a lot of them on there because it's very much the Black Ice mid-paced, mid-tier AC/DC songs. I almost felt Malcolm's background vocals missing a little bit on this album. Of course, he passed away, so he couldn't provide them. But I thought it was an okay album. I wasn't blown away by it, but there's some good guitar work. I think Brian Johnson sounds pretty good. But overall, I'd give it a 6 out of 10.
All right, Scott, have you checked it out?
I have not. I've heard bits and I've heard "Shot in the Dark." Like I heard the single,
right,
and I heard a couple tracks. But actually, it was sold out when I went to buy it Sunday.
Really?
So, yeah.
So. Did you go to Gallery of Sound?
I did go to Gallery of Sound, and I heard you were there before me that day.
Sunday. I was there before. I was there before that day. And actually, I put my name down for the CD, and they called me, and I picked it up today.
Oh,
but okay. I had streamed it though before that, so I'll get into my sure. next. Mr. Granza, have you heard it, buddy?
I did.
What do you think, my friend?
It's AC/DC.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
You know pretty much what you're going to get from it.
That's it. Yep. They're not reinventing the wheel.
Yeah.
But it's good. It's better than what I thought it would be. I enjoyed it.
Yeah. I like you said, I like that Demon something or other song.
Yeah, Demon Fire.
There's probably a good three of them that had that cool riff in there, and it's really, really catchy, and how they do that music and then stop and then go and then stop. And then that's the hook that I like of AC/DC. And then there's a couple snoozers in between, but it's pretty good. I like it. Yeah, it's a good one. I didn't pick it up yet, but I've been streaming it just to check it out, but I will pick it up.
Yeah, I really enjoy it. I was kind of lucky enough. Steve actually picked me up the red vinyl from Walmart, but I was streaming that from Apple the day it came out. And I think that they haven't released anything this good since at least Razor's Edge.
Wow.
I think this album is, for how old they are, and how long they kind of sat around a little bit. Mm-hmm. I really this album to me is, it's high. I'm gonna flip flop Dylan's numbers. I'm gonna transpose them. There, it's at least an 8.6.
Okay,
And they're all back now, right? Except obviously except Malcolm, but.
Yeah.
Isn't Phil back?
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
Demon Fire is great on a system. Down is good. Code Red is great. It's just, I think it's what you expect, but there was a little more element. I don't know.
I think a little more energy.
That could be exactly it. And it really
Brian
grabbed me from
good.
From
too.
Good.
His voice sounds really good.
Yeah. I really enjoyed it. I've probably listened to it probably 10 times by now. And I really enjoy it, and I think it has that extra energy to it. And I was going to say exactly what BB said. I think it's their best album since Razor's Edge, easily, because I think you have more. I mean, you don't have the Let There Be Rock, the Whole Lot of Rosie, that type of tempo song, but you do have more up-tempo songs on this than you've had on the last couple albums. And it's good. I really enjoy it. I think it's fantastic, you know. And it's actually better than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, yeah, I agree with that.
I definitely think it was better than I thought it was going to be. And I think that's what makes it even better, because my expectations were like, okay, it's going to be like another like Play Ball or Ball Breaker or something like that. Mm-hmm. The same, but it's just a step higher. It's more energetic, I think. And they seem like more energized, I think, than the last couple albums. So hopefully they can get out and tour. God only knows when.
Yeah. 2000 and never.
You know, I would like to see them do something.
Yeah.
You know, once they are allowed, you know, someone's allowed to go. Or even just, like, see them do a streaming thing, something.
Yeah.
You know, like, I love watching shit, like, when they're in the studio. Speaking of stuff like that, have you guys seen the big countdown on the KISS thing?
Yeah, yes. What is about?
Tomorrow, any guesses?
Tomorrow's the day.
It's tomorrow. So tomorrow by the time you guys hear this, it will have already happened.
Yeah.
Anybody have any thoughts on what it's going to be?
I have no idea. I mean, you could speculate. It's something
stupid.
It's going to be another greatest hits album.
That's exactly what I was going to say.
Better not be.
No. It's either going to be that or another stupid live album.
When's the
with
last
all
time
the same
the
stupid
countdown?
Songs they've been doing for the last 30 years.
The last time they did the countdown was on the ship. For the last day
for
of the
last
tour.
Day to the right. Tour.
It's got to be something.
Maybe it's
so,
that again.
Substantial.
So that's it. Says the hottest band in the world in the hottest performance in the world. So I'm thinking it's a live album, or maybe
a
live stream.
Something,
New Year's
maybe?
Eve. New Year's Eve concert.
It could be
pay per view,
or maybe they're just reannouncing their final show again.
Again.
Well, they say you're going to be blown away. What do they say? It's going to be
here's,
the ultimate.
Here's the new
or something.
Schedule for the.
Yeah. I hope it's something awesome, but they've been big of hyping shit, and you're like, that's it.
Yeah.
It'd be like a fucking KISS coloring book.
Easy now.
I'm just telling the truth.
Well, when was the last time?
Don't
they
be
did
one of them KISS fans that doesn't want to hear the truth.
When was the last time they hyped something big and you were disappointed? What was the last thing?
The big countdown on the ship. Oh, our last show was like so.
Yeah, but that was
well,
exciting.
People
got to
make plans.
That wasn't wasn't a true snoozer. That was.
You think that show's going to happen now on that date? No.
No.
Oh, that's why I didn't say.
That's
that
why
it's,
I think.
See,
that's why I think this is the new date.
Yeah, it could be. It could be. I think it's good. I think that they're going to release a DVD of the final
four.
From the end of the road. I think that's what it's going to be.
Oh, maybe.
I also want to point out, because it is a Friday.
I would take that.
It is a Friday, which is normally when new music is released.
New music is released.
So it could be
you may get a, you know, you may get a live album, DVD, Blu-ray, whatever. Who knows? but
Alive 4.
I just hope it's not like
from one to three.
Wah 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 moment when you're like, see, you're like, oh,
we'll have to
that's
revisit
it.
Next episode and see.
So
how,
I'm hoping. I am hopeful.
Right. Yeah,
doesn't sound it.
That's why I set you right next to me, buddy.
Yeah, maybe it's that. Maybe it's that documentary. They're doing some.
There was supposed to be some, some.
Yeah, there's a documentary.
It was supposed to come out in the fall or something.
Yeah, that's been in the works for like 18 years. Yeah.
It's a sequel to Kiss Meets the Phantom.
Oh,
somebody said online, maybe it's that magic book finally coming out.
No, the band doesn't have anything to do with that, though.
No, I know, but. Oh, God.
It's Tommy.
Did anybody here order that book?
No, I was going to. I thought you did, didn't
I did.
You?
I did.
Maybe I was this close to ordering it when you texted me, and I'm like, I don't know yet.
I did.
I'm so glad I waited.
Maybe they're hyping up
that
Freddie Vincent stuff.
That was 2 years ago you ordered
more
it?
More than that.
Yeah. He only sold
that's like 5 years ago.
Wow.
So like, could you guys do me a favor and announce it on your Facebook page?
Not yet.
Yeah, maybe.
It's for me right now, it's money spent. If it comes out, it comes out. If it's not, he'll be a pariah like Vinnie Vincent for the rest of his life.
Yeah. Why did you look at me, boy?
Because you're wearing a Vinnie Vincent shirt. That's why.
You're killed by association. Yep.
Absolutely, for sure. All right, so we all kind of like what we heard from AC/DC. And besides the new AC/DC, what are we listening to? How about you, BB? What do you got going?
The other day, off of, I like to get some vinyl off of Heavy E. I got the Black Label Society, Order of the Black, and the Catacombs of the Black Vatican. They kind of reissued the reissue, so they made a couple more copies, and I spun them the second I got it out of the box in the mail. So,
and you're welcome.
Thank you. Yes. Once again, thank you.
Because I saw it, I'm like, oh, BB's going to be all over this shit, yes. So I sent it right to him. Even though they didn't have a couple you were looking for.
Yeah, that one, Book of Shadows, is it's like
the Mafia too,
$300.
Right?
It's ridiculous, yeah. The Mafia, too.
But it's a start, though. It's a start. How about you, Granza? What do you listen to, my friend?
The Struts.
The Struts? Oh, they have
Struts,
a new one, right?
Yeah, and the Thunder Mother that you turned me on to from the cruise.
A new one? Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
A new one from them? Oh, really? Yeah,
really good.
I did not know that. I like
it. It's actually really good.
Yeah?
It's very good.
I'm going to have
to
check
it. Yeah,
it.
It's better than good.
Really?
It's
there's not a bad song on it.
Really good. It really is. And they played a couple shows a couple weeks ago.
Really?
Before they were shut down again. So they played some live stuff,
Definitely listen to that one.
Yeah.
They're a good band, yeah. I didn't
new bass player, though,
one.
Buddy. Different bass player from when we saw them on the cruise.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So your girl's gone, so you have to hook up the new one.
All right, then.
All right. Scott, how about you, my friend?
I'm listening to Ace's Origins Volume 2. I'm still digging that, been playing that. I'm always listening to classic rock stuff. So for me, to Old Thin Lizzy.
Nothing new.
I won't hold that against you.
Nothing new.
Okay. Rob, how are you?
Little jailbreak.
What do you got going, Rob?
Well, the newest stuff, like you, the Origins Volume 2, I've been listening to, but I've been replenishing my old vinyl. So, Screaming for Vengeance, I got the other day. I'm checking that out again. You know, I got a Guns N' Roses double greatest hits from Walmart.
Did you get the gray one?
Yeah. For $15. I'm like, that's not a bad deal. So I've been scoping that out. You know, I'm just going back down that vinyl road, you know, checking some old tunes out again, you know.
Wallet's going to be a lot lighter next year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. How about you, Dylan?
I was listening to some new stuff that was released. Alice Cooper's coming out the new album, Detroit Stories.
Yes,
released the first track off of that, Rock and Roll. Pretty cool track. I like it picks up at the end, which is really cool. And looking at the track list, it looks like a lot of the songs from Breadcrumbs, that EP he released, mm-hmm. are going to be on this new album. So it seems like I've heard almost half of this album already, which is interesting. But I also listened to the Pretty Reckless's new song, 25.
I heard that too. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Very cool.
Pretty
almost good. Like a Bond theme at times. It has that epicness to it that I really enjoy.
I like Pretty Reckless. They're good.
They're not bad. I wonder if if Alice's touring band plays on that album.
Could be, because...
I hope so.
I think,
but they didn't play on the Breadcrumb stuff.
No, they didn't. And, like, Don't Give Up is not on here, which is interesting, because I figured it would have been. But
this was probably done before he did that.
They did change
probably
the...
just rushed that out.
They did change the name of Detroit City 2020 to Detroit City 2021, since it's being released.
Right.
Again, next
That's
year.
Not bad. That was on the Breadcrumbs, right?
Yeah, like that one, Go Man Go, East Side Story, Sister Anne. Like, they're all on there.
Yeah, they weren't bad. We talked about that. I couldn't even tell you what episode it was.
It was a while back.
It was a long time ago. For me, new L.A. Guns. The Steve Riley version of L.A. Guns has an album out called Renegades. It's actually very good. It surprised you, like the actual band did? Yeah, it was good. It was good. Like, it's one of them. It's not as, like, out there as, like, the Motley Crue album with John Corabi. It's not, like, that far off of what Motley Crue was. But, I mean, you can definitely tell it's not Tracy Guns and Phil Lewis. But it's a good album. There's a lot of good songs on it. I am enjoying it.
And, hey, we enjoyed that version of the band live. They were fantastic.
Yeah, they were great. They were were the surprise of M3 that year. Absolutely. They were fantastic. That, and like I talked about last week, that Rob from Vancouver, Audrey Horn, fantastic band. I don't know how I missed these guys. You got to check them out. They are fucking fantastic. Them, I listened to the new Corey Taylor, CMFT, his solo album, fantastic. Going to make the list at the end of the year. And I got back into, the other day, I just watched a concert from a band that Sonny and Steven got us into from the Growing Up Rock podcast called Royal Republic. Fun band. If you want to just put on a band and they're just fun, like you'll literally find yourself like bebopping around your house with the headphones on listening to this band. Fun as fuck. So that's what we got going this week. BB's got some Black Label Society, Order of the Black, and Catacombs of the Black Vatican. Scott's got some Thin Lizzy and Origins 2, Screaming for Vengeance for Rob, and GNR Greatest Hits. Chris has got The Struts and Thunder Mother, which is very good. The Struts, I didn't get to check that out yet, though. I have it on my list to listen to. And Dylan's got some Alice Cooper and Pretty Reckless. And for me, new L.A. Guns, Audrey Horn. I keep on wanting to say Audrey Thorne.
Audrey Horn. And she gets what she
CMFT,
wants.
Which is Corey motherfucking Taylor, I'm assuming. And Royal Republic. So that's what we're listening to. Now, we'll get into the KISS stuff here. So, like I said before, we're making one album out of three albums and then the four songs from Killers. So we got Killers stuff, Creatures of the Night, Lick It Up, and Animalize. And for me, it was harder picking songs for this one than it was from the first three KISS albums.
Absolutely.
I'm like, oh, this is going to be easy. No problem. And I could probably go back and listen to the other one and say, no, I thought this was going to be easy, and it wasn't. Yeah. But this, now I have something to compare it to. This one was tough.
Yeah, it was very difficult.
I've had the playlist of all these songs on for like 3 weeks, I think I've been prepping for this. And I'm still not satisfied with my list and how it is.
It looks like you have two lists.
I do. I got shit all over the place here. But it's fun though. It was cool going back listening to that stuff there. So and I'll get into it when it's my turn for my list. But we're gonna start with Rob tonight. We'll do three, and I have BC's list too. BC can't be here. He's working. When we're done recording, I have to go relieve him. So I'm just on the iced tea tonight. Everyone else, well, water. Rob and BB are drinking.
Cheers.
Cheers. I'm a teetotaler tonight, literally. So Rob, give us your approach and your album, and
all right,
you're up.
So here's what I got. It was very difficult because it depends. Like, certain songs you get sick of. You're, like, tired of hearing those songs. So you leave them out, but yet they're fantastic songs. But they're just done to death live.
You have to unhear them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But if the thousand times you heard them since then.
If they were fresh, you'd be like, oh, that's a good one. That should be on there. So I'm going with that side of it. All right. So the title of my album is Kiss Fits Like a Glove, because all these songs fit like a glove. All right, so here we go. Side one, Down on Your Knees from Killers. Great song. Next one, number two, Keep Me Coming. So you got Down on Your Knees, Keep Me Coming. See what I did there? All right.
Tell the story.
You don't get out much.
He does not. All
right. Number three, Killer. Number four, Creatures of the Night. Killer.
So,
yes. Yes, he said you killer.
The same thing.
Killer, move on. Because you're a creature of the night.
This is a snuff film.
Should have called it Jack the Ripper.
All right. Five, Rock and Roll Hell. I wasn't going to put that on there, but I went back into it. And if you really listen to that, especially headphones, it's just got that, like, that demonic bass and just under it. Just, it's a great song. It's just something about it. And the way Gene sings it, it's just great. Six, War Machine, close up that side of the album. Side two, open up with Exciter, Paul Stanley screaming his lungs out. Awesome song, right? Number eight, Young and Wasted, love that. Eric Carr sang that fantastic when I saw them. Number nine, Fits Like a Glove, all-time favorite song for me, KISS song. Number 10, On the Eighth Day. Now, you guys think about that. I mean, it's kind of like Rock and Roll Hell. If you really listen to it, it just kind of gets you, and it just, so, all right, number 10, On the Eighth Day. 11, Close the Album, I've Had Enough, Into the Fire, off of Animalize, with another great Paul Stanley song. Then, I have for a bonus track for the Japanese vinyl, Not for the Innocent.
With the blood spit splatter.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, right? Not for the Innocent with Gene and Paul vocal demo version. Have you heard that one?
I hate it.
I mean, they gotta tweak it, everything, but I like the way Paul comes in and sings that part. If they produced it the right way, I like it.
Okay, that's right. My list.
What do you think of that, Scotty boy?
I like it, you know, and like I have to say, what Rob said, whatever he's going to say here, I mean, it's very difficult because
yeah.
I like all these songs. It's just a matter of, you know, putting them together, making a cohesive album. But so I don't think you go wrong with those choices, but I do like it. And I like it. Nice. Yeah, very good.
And Gene and Paul both are even just yeah. about, well, Gene might have had one or two extras, but, you know.
That'll never happen.
Not with Chris's list, it won't.
not with Paul Stanley's list either, his own.
Well, there's a reason. Paul's songs are better.
BB.
I liked it. I like the direction you went. I like the title and how it kind of fell in there. It's kind of funny. I think the only song I would have skipped would be probably On the Eighth Day, because I just
yeah,
doesn't get me. But is that the very last song?
Second to last.
Oh, okay.
I closed it up with I've Had Enough.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But
yeah,
on the eighth day, maybe because I didn't listen to it in so long, because I used to skip that one.
I love the...
But then I went back and listened to
the music and the verse of the... I listened to that today. I'm like, it just missed my...
Yeah, that's what happened. Because I revisited it. I'm like, I didn't realize how good of a song that really is. Because I literally used to skip that one all the time. I never really liked it. But now I kind of...
I still have my 1984 ears on. I'm sorry. Yeah. I take it back.
You should...
I
got to go back down. Just put some headphones on.
I just don't like the Gene screaming, oh, yeah, and that at the end of it. It reminds me of when Paul does that preachy shit at the end of, like, God Gave Rock and Roll to You, too. Like, that... Hallelujah. It has that kind of feel to it. And it's unusual for
hallelujah,
Gene.
Hallelujah, Ed. God Gave Rock and Roll to You, too. I don't think he says the word hallelujah.
Well, you know what I mean, how he does that whenever he does.
Stop misquoting him. Yeah. Rock and roll.
What do you think of it, Granza?
I agreed with most of it.
All the Paul songs.
No, it was a good list.
They're good ones.
We have some of the same ones on the list.
You know? Young and Wasted, that's a great song.
Yeah, I liked it, and I'm going to tell you right now, before we even get to my album, I did not put any songs from Killers on there because I think they're fucking terrible.
The only song I like, Down on Your Knees. It's just a good Paul easy song.
I don't
riff.
Like them. And the thing about those four songs
it's
are
catchy.
If they use those four songs to try out Michael James Jackson for the producer, how do they put him on the fucking album after he produced those four songs? They're terrible. The production's really thin on them, and they're just blah.
Well, they sound nothing like what he did afterwards.
No, I know, but I mean, how do they go?
I know.
How do you go from that to that?
I thought we had to pick one from those four songs. That's
oh,
what it was.
No, you don't have to.
I thought I had to.
But I like it, though, and I got it.
But so that is my favorite out of those four. If you had to pick one of those four, or go around the room, who would pick, what song would you pick from those four?
I'm a Legend.
You would pick I'm a Legend.
And I have Nowhere to Run.
And I have Nowhere to Run as well.
Steve?
I would have Nowhere to Run because they played that on the cruise.
Yeah, but it's what you personally like. You like that?
I don't really like them. I don't like any of them. But I only picked that one because I saw them playing.
Hmm. Yeah. Interesting.
I just like
Wait
the.
Wait a second, they played that on the.
I like the funk. Yeah,
well, Kiss didn't play.
No,
Kiss,
no.
Let me rephrase that. Bruce Kulick's band played that song.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, not Kiss. No, are you kidding me?
They played it.
They probably remember they had that song. Gene probably never even heard it.
I never heard of that.
What song did they play on the indoor show? From off there.
Keep Me Coming.
Really?
No.
Oh, from Killers.
From Killers?
Yeah, didn't they do one from
Kiss?
I don't think so.
No.
No.
Mm-mm. They did Keep Me Coming from Creatures.
I'm going to look that up.
And they did Is That You?
Yeah.
But they in Sweet Pain, but they didn't do anything from Killers. Kiss at any time.
Keep Me Coming was awesome.
Keep Me Coming was
that.
Very cool.
That's a great song.
All right. Scotty, how about your album?
What the hell was that double look for?
All right. Now my approach. So, I did include the hits. I'm trying to unhear them because I think they're great songs. We've heard them a million times, so I know
fresh
people
ears.
Are gonna.
A hit's a hit for a reason.
Right.
They got to make the album. They got to make the album. Yeah. So that was my a little bit of my philosophy. So I know people are going to hate me for it, but that's okay.
No, but you're right because I was torn too.
But I think I have a good mixture. So the name of my album is called New York Thunder. Came up with that, something wanted to kind of go with that theme. But okay, so starting off the album, Creatures of the Night.
Good opener.
Absolutely love it. Killer opener. Yeah, still, you know, to this day, one of their greatest openers, I think, in their set. So went with Creatures of the Night. Then I went for Not for the Innocent. I went with Lick It Up. I know that's not going to be on anybody's list because we've heard it 10 million times. A Million to One. I think A Million to One's top notch. Love that tune. So you can see I have quite a bit of... Lick It Up album on this list.
It's a great album.
It is a great album. Yeah. Rock and Roll Hell is next. Love it. I know Rob has that. Great killer tune. Great production. Love it. And then to end out side one, I finished with Nowhere to Run. Again, that's a tune off of the Killers album that I love. I love the riff. I love the whole jam to it.
I hate the chorus on it. That's what drives me crazy.
Okay.
It's like, save your love.
That's how you really
save
it.
Wow, Rob dissing on an Ace song. Wow, what the fuck?
The Ace song is great, but the chorus is terrible.
Save it. Save it.
Sorry.
No, that's okay. All right, side two. I Love It Loud. Had to include it. Kiss classic. But again, I know we've heard it a million times, but great tune. Love the original Creatures version. I got to definitely say that. Then I went with Exciter. Again, killer tune. I think a lot of folks are going to have that one on their list. If I had to guess, a lot of people at this table is going to have that one on this list.
Maybe not.
I then also went with Heaven's on Fire. I know, again, got to go with the hits. Got to go with the big songs.
I'm not disputing it.
You know, brings me back to a good time, too, in my life. I've Had Enough. Also, killer tune off Animalize. Great, great track all around. And then I did finish it up with War Machine. I didn't go with the closer there. So in a lot of ways, it's kind of funny when I look at it. I opened with Creatures. Side two was I Love It Loud. I ended with War Machine. So I kind of had a whole Creatures theme. But then a lot in the middle, I kind of went with the Lick It Up and Animalize stuff. But hope everybody liked it.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. Good run, good mix. I like it, and you have to, you know, and especially it's also your preference. You have to put the hits in there. It has to be something that you're going to enjoy listening to. And if you want to hear one of those songs that Lick It Up, you want to hear it. You like it. It's, you know, it's your album. You know, screw what Rob thinks. He doesn't want to put Lick It Up.
No,
on
I
want
Lick It Up on there.
But no, it's a great run of, you know, the hits and some deeper tracks on it.
Thank you.
I enjoyed it immensely.
Wow.
What else is there to say?
No,
Kiss songs.
I know. I mean,
let's face facts, fellas.
I like that it's a good mix of like the popular stuff and the deeper tracks.
Yeah.
And I there's tracks there that I have stuff to say about too when it's my turn. So
yeah. I know you're disappointed that he didn't include the Won't Get Fooled Again part.
Absolutely. They had to keep the album the time down on the album, so they're just saving that for live.
That's the single.
I take it you hate when they do that.
it's such a waste of time.
It's
it's
a nice homage to it.
No, they've been doing it for the last 18 years.
But it started on the Asylum tour, right?
I don't know. I didn't see the Asylum tour.
Yeah.
Well, they played one.
They didn't do it. They didn't do it on the Hot in the Shade tour, though.
No.
I don't remember.
Because I remember the first time that I saw it live was when they did it on the Rock, that was it, the Rock the Nations tour? Or no, Freedom to Rock tour, I think, was the first I saw them do it. I don't think they did it on Rock the Nations. I saw that. We saw that.
That's some good homework for people out there.
Let us know.
Comment in and let us know when they actually started doing that live.
I think 100% of the time I've seen them, they've done that.
It was back then. Asylum. To Asylum.
Yeah. They closed the show.
The first time I heard it, it was cool. And then after that, it got a little old. Well, it's still kind
of
cool.
But they did more of the song, though, right?
Yeah.
They did the whole song.
They did the whole song.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Because that's when they were even doing a whole lot of Love at that point,
that's
too, right?
That's true. But they wouldn't do the whole thing.
Right. Right. Just parts of it.
You know what? That triggered a memory. I feel like Paul did some of Whole Lotta Love on one of the shows that I saw him. It might have been like a vocal solo for him, and he did like the way down in, like that part. I hate to hear him do it now. Yeah.
What?
That
maybe he's gonna change your seat.
Like woke something in my mind.
This is my assignment.
Maybe. Happened.
I don't know.
Maybe. But. So if they did, there's more homework for you. If Paul did sing that, like, a cappella?
Yeah.
Let us know. What do you think of it there, Birdo?
I liked his list. His list was good. I would totally drop a million to one off that list. I'm not a big fan of that one. It's an okay song. It's kind of a skipper for me. But anywho.
You ain't right.
You know, it's an okay song.
All right, you don't have to like everything.
No, exactly.
All right, BB, what's your list?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Well, how'd you go about it?
I listened through all the albums, the four albums, and then kind of wrote shit down and scribbled shit out and scribbled some numbers and changed the order five or six times because I kind of went as this is going to be an actual vinyl. I want to keep it interesting that you still want to flip the album over and keep going. So the name of my album is Ace Who.
Oh, I do not like that title at all.
When you said that, I thought yours was going to be like, no ace, no problem.
Wow. Ace is low.
I knew it was going to be.
I could see like the picture of him, maybe like with the old Western, like missing at the KISS symbol up in the corner. Then like somebody spray paint like Space Ace, Spacey Blue, Ace Who on the bottom of it or something.
Like remember the wanted posters with Eric Singer on them?
Oh yeah.
Wanted dead or alive for impersonating a rock legend.
Yeah. Yeah.
Remember that? That was like when he first put the makeup on. Remember that?
The original
KISS convention.
Yeah.
I was like, that'd
be kind of funny.
That would not be funny at all, buddy.
I'm sorry. All right, so.
Now I know how you feel.
See? It ain't fun, is it?
The Paul Stanley bastard, yeah. It's not fun at all.
I want to go home. I want to take my list and go home now. Just like they opened up Animalize, they had a great song, I've Had Enough. When they produced that album, I think they hit the nail right on the head. That first guitar chord, that heavy drum beat, Paul screams, come on. Great way to start the album. The shredding in this song is amazing. The band gang vocals at the chorus is fucking fantastic. Loved that song. Definitely had a... I knew that was going to be my album opener from the start when we talked about this. The piggyback, a heavy song, I'm going with Exciter from Lick It Up. I love the chugging riff throughout it. I think that little verse when they say whisper my name and he goes Exciter. I think that's kind of that's kind of cool. It is like a rock end, cool rock ends to that song.
Oh, you guys get excited.
But I like it. Exciter. It gets me excited for Exciter. So song number three, this is where I'm going to put my hit. I had to pick Creatures. Eric Carr's drumming on this song is just, you know, mind blowing. You know, God rest his soul. And that's just one of those songs that I think it's a hit, but it's not like a hit that you're sick of.
Right.
Number four, I'm gonna turn the pace down a little. This is where I'm gonna throw in a million to one. I love Paul's tones, vocals on this song. Vinny's solo's fantastic on this. I always like Eric's and Vinny's like background vocals through that whole album of Lick It Up. I really, 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 really like that. Song number five, I'm going back to Animalize to Get All You Can Take. Great opening riff.
That's a good one.
The solo starts off nice and slow, and then it like picks up Desmond Child, the background vocals on this, really, really cool. And I probably think one of the only songs in Kiss's catalog that has the word fuck in it.
Yeah.
So, like, you know what? We'll throw it in there just for shits and giggles. See if, see if I can get a parental sticker on the other corner of the put something there that, that
sell a couple more records.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Right? Who? Warning.
And then I'm going to close side one with the song Gimme More from Lick It Up. Another fast-building song. Another great solo. Vinny goes. In the way Paul screams that vocal, his vocal sometime in that, like, I really think Paul, I love Paul's vocals through the 80s.
You pretty much have Gene, a Paul Stanley solo.
So far, I'm gonna throw Gene in a little bit.
I'm hoping
because
you
after
throw
I got
bone.
Done the song
Don't
seven,
worry, you're gonna get the opposite of that in a little while.
Because when we did the other one, I'm like, man, my album is very Gene heavy. And then I noticed, I'm like, boy, this is very Paul heavy. I better find a Gene song to throw in there. But all right, so that closes side one. Side two, we flip it over. We're going back to Creatures with Danger. Another cool, heavy guitar riff. Another great drum opening. Just a great way to chug along the opening riff, their opening song for the second side. This is where I'll throw Gene in, because Gene's getting a little cranky every once in a while.
He is very cranky.
You know, he's like, what the hell? I'm like seven songs in, you don't hear me?
Yeah, seven songs in, I need one.
And I kind of like to mix it up, but this is where I went Creatures. So this song, I picked Killer. It has that dark Creatures feel to it. And like, just, there's some crazy, crazy lyrics that are really, really cool in there. It's something about like Crack the Whip and Submission Trip. Just really, really cool. Like Gene lyrics, fantastic.
Vinnie Vincent,
great lyrical as that Mr. Gene is. But he's finally there at number eight. Song number nine. This is where I wanted to throw something from Killers in. So if somebody doesn't want to, you know, it's deep in there. I'm like, yeah, it's skippable nine. So that's where I put Nowhere to Run. I love it. It has that 70s feel. It almost feels like it should be off of like Paul's solo album. Bob Kulick solo is fucking sick bananas on that fucking song. So that's where we're going to throw the Killer song, because like Rob, I'm like, I might as well throw Killers in there somewhere.
Yeah, a little squeeze one in there.
Then maybe song number 10, this may be, I think they actually did release this song on as a single, but I love this song, Thrills in the Night. It has that perfect 80s feel to it. The way Mark plays on this with that whammy bar and before he starts into his actual solo, this is a perfect 80s radio Kiss hit that really didn't go anywhere.
What song?
Thrills in the Night.
Okay.
So I'm going back to Creatures for song 11, Keep Me Coming. Good. Once again, Eric's drumming in this is so fantastic. Eric's like the MVP of Creatures. And since I don't understand to stop at 11, I balanced my album. I went to 12, and I finished out with the heavy Animalize song, Under the Gun. I think that's like the hidden gem of Animalize. Great heavy riff. Mark St. John's playing in that is so fucking fast. And, once again, another, God rest his soul tool as well, because it just seems like all this amazing shit, two of them are not around anymore, but... I guess I'll dedicate my album to them too, because this fucking album kicks ass.
There you have it, Steven.
All right. I took Granza's words right off his mouth.
Good Paul Stanley semi-solo album there.
Yeah.
Not bad. Pretty much.
Before I let Dylan go, out of listening to all the songs for these albums, for your album, which production would you like for your album? Would you like the Killers, the Creatures, the Lick It Up, and the Animalize? Because they're all very distinct and different. So, like, if you were doing this album, what production would you like on your album?
Animalize for Dylan? Me, yeah.
Creatures.
Creatures? Yeah, Scott, Creatures? BB?
Yeah, I'm going to say Creatures as well.
Chris?
I have to say Lick It Up.
I'm going to say...
Killers.
I'm going to say probably, yeah. I want it to suck.
What's that?
I want it to sound sin. I'm torn between Lick It Up and Animalize. I'm going to go with Animalize because I like the drum sound a little better.
Yeah.
I think the Creature's drum sound is a little distracting. I think it distracts, I think, from some of the songs. And like I said before, I think that they use that drum sound to make you not think that Ace is not there.
Interesting.
I thought they went...
Like how they turned up the rhythm guitars. I think they just tried
wanted to be
all.
Much, much heavier to say,
yes.
Our last album sucked balls.
Get rid of the Elder.
We want to come back,
we
and this is we're really loud.
We're a heavy
rock.
Band.
That's, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? The way I think exactly.
Yeah. So I would probably go with Animalize's.
We have quite the hodgepodge of guitar players on here, really, if you think about it.
And if you had to pick a guitar player, who would you pick? Would you pick Bob Kulick, Bruce Kulick, Vinnie Vincent, or I know who your answer is, BB. or Mark St. John.
Wow.
That's a good question. Think about it.
Yeah.
Probably Bruce.
Because it depends what song they're playing, you know, because you know who played what.
What about Rick Derringer? Yeah, doesn't he play a song on, doesn't he play a solo in one of those songs?
Yeah. Yeah. Creatures had a lot of guests.
BC's going on a call.
Guitarist. Yeah. Yeah, I'd have to go with either Bruce or Bob, I think. Probably Bruce. But, you know.
It's tough to pick.
It's hard to pick. Yeah. But I...
And you're also different.
And I'm going to go with BB, because I think Vinny's guitar sounds fucking fantastic on Lick It Up. His solos are ripping, and I love the guitar tone. Because then you could tell that Exciter's not him, if you listen to the rest of the album, the solos on that.
Yeah. And it's not terrible like with Vinnie Vincent's Invasion, like when that came out.
His solos
were just ridiculous.
They didn't fit the songs.
No, they
didn't fit the songs.
It was like a totally different song in the middle.
Right.
So, yeah, you're right. On that, they toned him down and they said, hey, you know, do it how you slow it down a little bit.
Right. Well, I think that's why the Invasion album was like it was, because he didn't have Paul and Gene saying, settle down.
Pump the brakes a little.
Absolutely.
All right, so... Did we talk about BB's list, anyone?
BB's it's Paul good. Stanley solo album.
I love it.
we match. The PS2.
And a million to one should be on your list.
it was interesting. You had actually a couple songs that were in the same positions as I had them. And I'm like, oh, my God, was he like at a – but there's a lot more difference, but – I was getting nervous there for a second. I'm like, I might not have much interesting to talk about. But.
There's always interesting shit to talk about.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, so there's three. We did Rob, Scott's, and BB's. We're going to do a gem song, and then we'll do my friend Chris here to my right, myself, and Dylan will wrap up. And I will read BC's list before I do mine.
It'll be the bonus.
BC's will be the Japanese bonus album. All right, so this week... I discovered a song, and this band played on Monsters of Rock Cruise, and it was one of the few bands that I insisted to myself that I see both shows. The band is Thunder, because they never play in the States, and I'm thinking this is the only time I'm ever going to get to see these guys. They put out a new song. It's called Last One, Turn Out the Lights. It's a single that they just put out. Song is fantastic.
Yeah.
Dylan, I played it for Dylan last night.
Played it for me yesterday. I was blown away by how just... kick-ass rock and roll it is.
It's great. It's got a little whole lot of love kind of little guitar thing in it a little bit in parts of the album. It has the like female backup singers.
I was gonna say the background vocals and the chorus is really
fantastic.
Good.
Absolutely fantastic.
Is Beth played on that one? Or is she on the Thunder Mother?
She may be on the... I think she's on the Thunder Mother. I'll have to look that up.
Because I remember
her posting
that she was doing backup vocals.
Yeah, so that wasn't Thunder, though, because you could tell it's like singers. Like not
Are
just
you
like
Beth wasn't a singer?
No, you know what I mean, like background singers like you get with
like
the 976 girls.
I'm with
like
you.
Like that, you know what I mean?
I'm with you.
All right, so Dylan is going to play Last One Out, Turn Out the Lights by Thunder.
Another word, and now
All right, hidden gem time. We're going to do just the Potter Than Hell boys for the gems this week. We're going to give Scott, Chris, and Rob a break here for a couple more minutes. And Dylan, what do you got for us first?
I believe I talked about this album a while ago, but I'm going to pick a specific song from it. Metallica, back in 2019, released an acoustic live album that was to benefit something called Helping Hands Live and Acoustic at the Masonic. The song that I want to focus on is an acoustic version of Hardwired.
Oh, really?
It's basically just like the actual song, but played on acoustic guitar, so it's like the heavy, like...
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's really fun. It's really... it's a fun interpretation of it, so it's like James is... We're so fucked. Shit out of luck. And they're just playing it on the acoustic guitars instead of doing an acoustic arrangement
of it. Or something, yeah.
Because they do acoustic arrangements of a couple different songs, like All Within My Hands from the best album, Saint Anger.
That's cool. I'll have to check that out.
It's a really cool. They do a cover of Blue Oyster Cult's Veteran of the Psychic Wars. But Hardwired is my gem.
All right. BB.
All right. Since my KISS album was so heavy, I have to turn it back and turn it down a little bit. I'm going to pick the Desmond Child live album from 2019. He's on there playing the piano. I think it's more of a Broadway band. Young kid playing guitar. Vocals are fantastic. But it's a great little set list he does. 12 songs, Living on a Prayer from Bon Jovi he does, Angel from Aerosmith he does, Hate Myself for Loving You from Joan Jett. And then he does, actually it was I Hate Myself for Loving You by Joan Jett, but he does I Was Made for Loving You by Kiss. And it's in the this young kid from Broadway plays the guitar, sings backgrounds, and does the high parts of Paul singing on it. Really, really good album. It's just very light album. Great. He does a little story, this and that, every once in a while about some of the songs, but really, really different.
Almost like a storyteller,
kind of, in a way. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's cool. I never even heard of that. I didn't know he was still doing shows and stuff.
Yeah, and I think on PBS there's a video. I think the video is of this concert.
Well, that's cool. Yeah. Oh. Cool. So Desmond Child live.
Yeah.
Interesting. Okay. And for me, I was checking out, the song actually just came up on, I was watching YouTube videos and it came up and I hadn't seen it before. So I put on friggin' excellent. Whitesnake from the Purple album, the song Stormbringer. Reb Beach and Joel Holster absolutely tear it up on this song. The whole album is really good. It's all like Whitesnake doing Deep Purple stuff from when David Coverdale and Glenn Hughes were in the band from Burn and from Stormbringer. So check it out. The whole album is really good, but Stormbringer just absolutely freaking rips. And which I don't get, they did a live album too. They did like the Purple Tour, and they have the Purple live album. Stormbringer isn't on the live one. I'm like, what the? Like, it's like one of the most well-known Deep Purple songs from that era, and it's on the studio album, but they didn't put it on the live album. But I know there's some regular Whitesnake songs in there too, so maybe they cut it, but absolutely fantastic. So there's our gems. We have Desmond Child live from BB. We have Metallica acoustic doing Hardwired to Self-Destruct acoustic, which I want to hear that. That's cool. I love when they do shit like crazy
play
shit
free,
like that.
Play it for you after the show.
Okay. And I hope you enjoyed our song by Thunder, last one, Turn Out the Lights. Their new single that they have out is available. I'm sure you can get it on Spotify. I got mine on Apple Music. So let's get back into our KISS album. And Chris, you are up, my friend. What do you got for us? You have the full Paul Stanley solo album, don't you?
I thought I was going to, but I actually do not.
He also threw Gene a bone.
No, I got a couple of Gene songs.
Did you put a log in his fireplace?
Can you turn that off?
he was hitting the highway doing 69.
Somebody's going to get an elbow. Right? The people's elbow? You want the people's elbow?
People's elbow.
I'll give you the people's elbow. All right. This one was very difficult for me, and I was just going to actually just bring up the Lick It Up album and leave it at that because that's how I feel. But it's a great record. It really is.
You think
helps.
That's the best of the three?
We'll rank them. We'll rank them at the end.
Okay. Start to finish, there's not a bad song on it. There really isn't.
You're right.
You know what I mean? But anyways, I named my record No Time for Makeup. Okay? First song is Creatures in the Night. I love the way the drums come in. Makeup.
Flogged down the
stairs.
We're
not talking about makeup, that kind of makeup.
Oh, no time for makeup.
Yeah.
No time.
No time to makeup.
No time. Yeah, you should throw a two in there.
It's
no,
a play on words.
To die.
His album.
All right.
Thank you, Stephen.
You're welcome. I'm in your corner, buddy.
Okay.
Well, we'll see what else you pick. Then
next up, Heaven's on Fire. It's a great tune. Like I said before, it hits a hit for a reason. Okay. Then we're going right into I Love It Loud. Yeah. I was going to put Rock and Roll Hell on there, but it just, I Love It Loud is a staple. Then we go to Exciter, and then War Machine. Mm. Okay, right?
That's a good side one.
Love it.
Yes, sounds familiar.
Scott's loving it.
Then on the other side, flip side, kicks off with Lick It Up. It's just it's a classic Kiss tune. It's short and sweet, gets right to the point. Then right into a... You're going to hear it. You don't look at it. A Million to One. One of the best songs ever.
Hmm.
I can give you... Then you have to have a ballad on a record.
You just had one.
That was a rocking ballad.
It's not a regular ballad. It's ballad-esque.
Whatever.
Ballad.
I Still Love You is absolutely phenomenal. Okay? Then I've Had Enough. From Animalize.
That's what Rob said about your album.
That's what Chris said about your attitude.
Whose side are you on? Never mind.
I'm in the middle. All right, I'm just adding fuel to both fires.
Okay. Then Thrills in the Night, which is a fantastic song. Absolutely love it. And then to close out the record, End on the Eighth Day.
Ooh, good closer.
Is that all? You don't like anything else?
No, I do. It's a good one. Yeah. I like it.
I think it's good.
Should I go first? Being he's all over me.
Go ahead.
Well, you were all over me. It was my turn.
Let me tell you, side one kicks ass. Side two, it's a little up and down.
It's supposed to.
No, I know it is. I Still Love You is a great song. Right. I kind of like that better than A Million to One. It's a good song. Just saying. A Million to One is okay, but
this was
I Still
the
Love You is a great. Paul vocally on I Still Love You is phenomenal.
I personally love it because I think we have eight of the 11.
Well, great minds sing alike.
Right.
I don't know what the hell the rest of you are thinking.
How about your bonus track?
Well, I when I was listening to everything, I was writing.
Christopher, you're stuttering, buddy. What do you got?
You got him flustered.
Well, I know.
I had a
bonus,
I
Christopher.
I had a total of 22 songs that I really wanted on this record, and I had to narrow it down to the 11. So my
bonus.
Probably has to be either Not for the Innocent.
Ooh.
Or
with the Jean Paul vocal,
maybe.
No,
hopefully
come
not. You're coming
terrible.
In my corner.
Straight up.
That's
or,
good for you.
Huh?
Good for you.
Or
no, I'm saying with a better production,
I would say. Under
with a better production.
Which one?
It was Not for the Innocent or Under the Gun.
Okay. Alrighty.
He threw me under the bus too already.
Good job, buddy.
No, I liked it.
I'm gonna have to listen on the eighth day because once again, it's that didn't even make my original list. So now I really
On the Eighth Day it was a good pick.
Yeah, that was a close call for me. It was either that or War Machine. You know, I was kind of weighing the two.
Yeah, and I Still Love You. That's one song that the drums are like, holy fuck. When I did the interview with Joey Quesada. And we talked about that. There's a video, what?
Nothing. I'm listening.
Oh, there's a video of them, of him, Pauly Z, and maybe Rudy Sarzone. I forget who played bass on that. Doing "I Still Love You" like right after David got killed in that accident in Florida.
Oh, I saw that.
And Joey, I was obviously drumming on it, and I've heard it covered a couple times. And Joey's the only one that I've heard play that song correctly, besides Eric Singer. There's one part where there's this one drum fill, like it's like right in the middle of the song, but it's like a shuffle. And Joey is the only person I heard fucking play that right. The drums on that make the song for me. Paul's voice is fantastic. I love his vocals when he does it on Unplugged better than on the Creatures album.
True.
But I like the drums. The drums don't distract me as much on I Still Love You on Creatures because it makes it a more powerful song. I think, on that album, where it kind of, for me, takes away on some of the other songs, but absolutely love it on there. And Thrills in the Night, I'm kind of meh on that as well. It's okay. It was cool that they did it on the Animalize Live on Uncensored. That was kind of cool when they did it on there. But good album, though. And another one that picked on the Eighth Day. I like that. I was so close to picking that song. BB, you got to give it a chance.
I will.
Check out the. How could you not like it? It's co-written by Vinny. What the
fuck? Of course. I used to skip it. I did. I used to. That was a skipper for me for years. I used to skip that. And then when I revisited it,
I wonder about it. Did you say there was a funky part towards the end with Gene or something?
Steve said that.
Maybe that's.
He doesn't like the way he screams at the end. But he's very emotional at the end.
Yeah. I love it.
I don't know.
Yeah, I do too.
It's a great record.
I want a girl from Gene.
Yeah. No, he's hitting his high notes. I don't know what he's doing.
I know. Yeah, I have a lot of the same songs. So
again, great minds think alike. Appreciate that.
All right. We'll do, actually, I forgot, I'll do BC's next. You're going to probably have to.
That we're just making them the Japanese bonus.
Steve, we are. Okay, that's right.
Are you tallying up to see how many we doubled and everything, like all the way around?
No.
Just
curious. Yeah, why don't you queue it up when everybody I'm doing mine?
I will.
So then.
No.
I think everybody has Exciter.
I didn't.
So I think everybody has Exciter.
Not yet. You got two to go.
We'll have to.
Everybody has War Machine so far.
Got two to go.
I don't.
Right? Oh, you didn't have War Machine?
Not have War Machine.
We do.
Oh, I thought you had War Machine too.
I did.
Okay, better watch out.
All right, it was difficult for me, and I was thinking just when we were talking about it, the next three albums are going to be harder, I think, because the next three, not the next three that we made, we'll do different ones, but like the next three in line with these, you're gonna have chronologically. Thank you, Dylan. We're gonna have Asylum, Crazy Nights, Hot in the Shade.
So that's it can't be done.
It will be done.
It cannot be done.
It will be done.
Just turn on the
But that's going to be insane to do.
Tracks 1 through 11.
It's going to be challenging.
It's going to be very challenging.
Very challenging.
So fantastic. And that's another, you know, production thing, too. They're totally different sounding albums, too. All right, so for me, I had 17 songs that I picked out of these albums. I only had one from Killers, and I didn't use it. I called my album Rock and Roll Hell. I'm opening my album with, which would never in a billion years happen, like, on any fucking universe, I'm opening the album with Young and Wasted with Eric Carr singing it.
Ooh.
Breaking the rules.
Total rocker, right out of the belt. When he does that, when he sings that on Animalize Live Uncensored,
I thought we were like, taking it from the actual albums. I didn't think we could, like,
no, we are, but dream. I'm just, that's what made me want to do that.
Steven changes the rules as he goes.
That's what made me want to do that. I can change a vocal.
That should be the bonus track, not the opening track. Like,
but I said you can.
I was going to say that.
And I want War Machine, but with Paul singing.
No.
I can't come up with 10, so we're going to make it 11.
All right, maybe
I got nothing.
Move that down to your bonus track.
No, that's my opening track. Fuck you guys. And then, little Under the Gun. They're going to hit the highway doing 69, next second song. Heaven's on Fire. Absolutely right, Chris. Hit for a reason. And then Gene gets his shot at the title here. Fits Like a Glove. That was a live staple forever.
Yeah.
They even did that in Hot in the Shade Tour.
Yeah.
Freaking awesome.
We went nuts when they played that. That was fucking awesome. And then
I put that in my yearbook as my favorite song.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
You put I Can't Drive. Because
it was that time.
I did not.
You did. I saw it with my own eyes.
You're wrong. And then, and I 100% agree with you, Chris. Million to One is next. And I cannot fucking believe how they did not listen to this song and put that out as a single. I could see them putting out Lick It Up first. You know, okay, Kiss is rocking back. It's a good, catchy song. How could they not have put Million to One out as a single? Like, what the fuck? Still put out All Hell's Breaking Loose after that.
Yeah. One shot.
And that, but I think that's another song, like Forever, that it was out, and if it was anyone else, if that was a Bon Jovi song or a Def Leppard song, it would have been fucking massive.
True. Yeah,
but
because
it was Kiss, it was not. Million to One is fucking absolutely fantastic. When Paul did that on the Live to Win tour, fucking kick ass. Excellent. Then I wrap up my first side with Not for the Innocent, the version from Lick It Up, as it should be. I open up side two with All Hell's Breaking Loose. I don't give a shit about that rap part. It's a great song. The solo in it is friggin' fantastic. Then I've Had Enough Into the Fire. Great song. And then I got a little sleeper here, ooh, pun intended, while the city sleeps. I love the down-on-on-on.
Oh, Black and Blue.
I love that song. Yes. Absolutely. Fake Ace is playing there. Fake Freely.
Ooh, ooh,
the Replace Man.
The Replace Man. I forgot about the Replace Man.
What's going on?
And then we do a little Keep Me Coming from Creatures. And then I end the album out with War Machine. I think it's a great ending. And I like that ending of that song harkens me back to the end of Black Diamond on the first album. You get that kind of that little murky kind of feeling at the end. And then I do have a bonus track that is my title track, Rock and Roll Hell. It's going to be my Japanese bonus
track. That's the boat?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, the song that you named the album after.
It's a sales thing.
Is Brian Adams singing Rock and Roll Hell?
Ooh. He is not. Okay. He's not.
Just curious.
He plays piano on it.
Ah.
It's the Toad the Wet Sprocket version. That's right.
All right.
Yeah. Can we comment? It's a good list. Interesting that you ended with War Machine, and you'll find out why after everybody comments on it, but pretty solid list. Well, because it has to do with my list.
Oh, okay.
Why I'm saying that.
Oh, right. You guys share the computer?
What? No.
His probably opens up with it.
Well, we'll find out. Rob, what do you think?
Yeah, your list was good. It was all right. It was good. We had a lot of... I'd be interested to know how many repeats we have. Like, who's got,
how many crossovers?
Tally that up.
We could take a break.
Yeah.
Before we wrap up, and we can tell him real quick.
Just to see, how many...
We'll do that.
Did everybody get one? To get
away. Great list. I like it a lot. We have a lot in common, too. So I think, you have to throw a couple hits on there. I think you really do. I mean, I know that's just my philosophy, but no, I love it. Can't go wrong with these songs and these albums.
Yeah, I love All Hell's Breaking Loose, but I hate that spoken word. He looks me up and he looks me down. But the fucking chorus and the solo is amazing. But that opening two verses, man, it kills me.
What be this and what be that?
Yeah, I know.
Why you gotta look like that?
Exactly. Like, I don't understand it, but if you could skip the first two verses and start there, great song.
I like those other parts so much that I could just say fuck it to those other parts.
It is a great song. He's just... I don't know why they did that. It's just so silly.
I think that part makes the song. It's different. It's attitude.
You picture him walking down the road, strutting his stuff.
In his blue thong.
Look me down. Oh,
what?
Wow. Why do you got to go there?
That's two albums from now.
But that video was the same set as Motley Crue, Too Young to Fall in Love. I mean, they basically copied it.
And it was pretty much the same as Lick It Up, too.
Yeah.
Well, they probably shot them both on the same day.
Yeah, they probably did.
Yeah.
I would say so.
All right.
I enjoyed your list. I really did.
Yeah.
Some classics.
I don't understand Rob's hatred for Million to One.
Well, he's not right.
I'm not. There's no hatred. It's just okay. It's a skipper for me. It's not really a skipper. I'll listen to it, but I don't love it.
It's a Gilligan.
I don't love it.
I understand.
You know what I mean?
No problem.
Yeah. It's just... It's a great song, but I just don't... it's not the best song on the album, that's for sure.
Well, I didn't say it was the best song on the album.
I did.
You did. Is that your favorite KISS song? Oh, it's not your favorite KISS song ever.
It's in my top five.
Okay.
Is it?
Absolutely.
Hmm. Wow.
From the first time I
heard
it.
That's all it will be.
Yeah. Yeah.
You guys ain't right.
All right, Dylan.
Okay.
I should be drinking.
See? The way I went about this list, it was literally a knee-jerk reaction type of thing because I knew I was going to second-guess myself and I was going to be, what be this and what be that, just going through the list. And,
why you got to think like that?
Why'd you got to make a list like that?
And constantly second-guessing myself. So I went on instinct. I threw out the 11 songs that jumped out to me at first, and actually I really like the order that I put them in, so I kept them in that order, and actually I feel like it works out pretty well, but you guys be the judge of it. I have three different titles for it. I like to think of it as like a Killing Machine, Hellbent for Leather situation, where certain areas maybe got a different title. One of the titles is Animal Knights, kind of combining Creatures of the Night and Animal Eyes.
I like that one.
The second title is Rock the Nation. And then the third title I'm stealing from one of the live videos, Exposed, because it's coming after pretty soon after the Unmasked era, and they were starting to unmask, so it's like they're exposing their faces and themselves in more ways than one.
Cool. I like the Animal Knights.
Yeah.
That's a good one. That's a keeper.
Yeah, I like all three of them.
I like Exposed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I a little something for everybody.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So, as predicted, I opened my with War Machine, the first track. I always felt like Gene should get more opening tracks. He doesn't
get one till Revenge.
Revenge is the first time. But War Machine, I feel like it's a nice moody opener that sets the tone. And then we go into Exciter, so we get the Paul track right after that. Really great, fast-paced song that I really enjoy. Then we go into the Falling Down the Stairs for Creatures of the Night. The drums always sound like they're somebody fell down the stairs, but in a good way. Then we go into I've Had Enough into the Fire. I love the energy of that song. I really like the Animalized guitar crunch from Mark St. John. And then we close out side one with Rock and Roll Hell. Nice little ender for the first side of the album. It's like, get me out of here, you know? We want to get out of hell, but of course we can't go to heaven because we're opening up side two with Heaven's on Fire. So we can't really get in there because it's on fire. Eat it like a piece of cake. You know, great lyric. Then we go into Killer, Stone Cold Killer. Really great. I love this song. It's this is the Gene that I like. Then we go into All Hell's Breaking Loose with the rap part attached. I like it personally. I'm a fan. This is a song that I was surprised nobody else had on their list. Murder on High Heels.
Murder.
I love that. Ooh. That's such a fun. It's a fun riff, and I love Gene's delivery of the murder in high heels.
Yeah,
it's got that old school feel. Very, I like it very much. Then we're gonna end the album with Fits Like a Glove. Mm. You know, must be love. And then my bonus track is gonna be Lick It Up, just to have it on there as like a almost like how they put Beth as the B-side to Detroit Rock City.
Yeah.
I pictured them, but it's like, you know, maybe we'll throw this song out there, see if people like it. And then it ends up being one of the bigger songs.
Yep.
Yeah, so that's my list.
Nice.
That was a good one. That was a good one. I liked it. That was a very good list.
Thank you.
Yeah, your first side has, I have every song on it.
So yep.
Yep. Love it.
Yeah, Dill, you're actually right. Like, as you're going through, I'm like, oh, wait, I had that one at that spot. I had that one in that spot. I had that one in that spot. I like how you actually had a couple titles, you know. And once again, you know, there's really not really a bad song here except for a couple. But, you know, another great list. You can't say anybody has a bad list, but great list.
Yeah, we're just picking.
Yeah.
Nitpicking,
exactly.
I really dug it. Yeah. Classic stuff.
Yeah, good list. I like the thought you put into it. I like the titles.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm. It all blended together nicely.
All right, let me give you BC's. His album is called The Hell That Should.
Of course. The Hell That Should.
The Hell That Should. Should. I'm not really sure if that was a typo. Should. That's what it says, right?
Yeah, the hell that.
All right,
should.
So BC, you're gonna have to explain yourself next week. Not really sure what that
Maybe
is.
Maybe it's a reference to the song that I wrote for my band, Hell I've Earned.
That could be. Maybe. All right, so his album is I've Had Enough Into the Fire, Fits Like a Glove, Keep Me Coming, Million to One, I Still Love You, Down on Your Knees, Creatures of the Night, Rock and Roll Hell, All Hell's Breaking Loose, Young and Wasted, and Under the Gun.
Nice,
good.
He's got a good list.
He's got a good list, too.
He's got Down on Your Knees on there, too.
I know.
Yeah.
We have the same opener and closer, so maybe me and BC should be...
The Killer Bees.
We should be producing albums.
The Killer Bees. I like that. Mm. No, he's got a good list. I like his list. That's a solid.
Just the name has me thrown a little bit.
We don't know about the name there. We got
to... We'll have to
dig deeper on that one.
The little legend that could, the hell that should.
That's right. All right, so we're going to pause for a second, and Dylan, and I'm going to tally up who picked what.
Okay, we'll be right back after these messages.
This is Vinny Vincent. You're listening to the Potter Than Hell podcast. Don't miss it.
All right, the votes are in,
and they're all in this time. Yep. We even did a recount, and they all came out the same. So we're good.
Okay.
We're good.
Topical.
All right. So you got all our lists, and what we did was we tallied up how many people picked each song.
Yes.
So Dylan's going to read off the top ones for us.
Yes. So there was only one song of the entire draft that we could pick that had everybody have it on their list, and it was I've Had Enough, Into the Fire, off of Animalize, well-earned spot. There were a couple that came close. The next closest with 6 out of the 7 people is Creatures of the Night off of that album. But then we had a couple of 5s, where 5 people picked. And those were Rock and Roll Hell, War Machine, Exciter, and Million to One. And everything else was 3s, 2s, 1s, and 0s.
I think it was pretty well balanced, Gene songs, Paul songs.
Yeah, mine was. Mine was 5, 6. Yeah.
Mine was.
I think it was.
Except for some of us.
BB's was very Paul heavy.
Yeah, it was Paul heavy.
Paul
which
heavy.
I thought it would have been very. Granza's that would have been.
That's what I thought, too.
So did I.
Paul.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I started listening to them.
I tried to balance mine out.
Now I question I your Paul loyalty now.
Paul Stanley's questioning it.
We were making one record, so I had to balance it. That's the way I went it. I tried to balance everything out, keep everybody happy. I'm trying to please the masses here.
True. Yeah. That's right.
That is true. Some of us.
I did it on my favorite.
That's
songs.
Like BB wouldn't even sign the contract like Vinnie Vincent. That's why his was so Paul heavy.
Nice.
All right. So let's. The 4 albums we did, well, we'll count Killers as an album. So we got Killers, Creatures, Lick It Up, Animalize. Rob, rank them.
Oh, not just pick my favorite, but pick.
Rank them. Put them in order.
Well, I'm going to it's tough. Between Creatures and Lick It Up is very tough because it's very tough. But song for song, I'm going to have to go with Lick It Up, then Creatures, then Animalize, and then Killers. Now, Killers, I'm just counting those 4 songs.
Right.
I'm not counting
Does anyone have Killers anywhere besides number 4?
No.
All right. Okay. So just don't even count that one.
All right. I'm just counting
they suck anyways.
Songs. We can't count the other songs because they're classic KISS songs.
Right. Yeah. Some of the remixes are a little
funky. Different.
Yeah. Scott.
Okay, it's very different. I mean, it depends which day you ask me. That's but but I will say, I would probably, well, first of all, I mean, if you like KISS at their heaviest, these are the 3 you got to rotate to. These 3 albums are just kick-ass. So, but I would say, if I had to rank them, I would put Creatures over Lick It Up by a hair. It's that close. Those are 2 just fantastic albums. And I like Animalize a lot, too, and that's not taking away from Animalize. So I would rank them in the order of release. I would go Creatures is the best, then Lick It Up, then Animalize.
I think, Scott, I think that's the best. What you just said is amazing. Like, it has to be your mood. It's like whatever mood you're in. It's like, because there's time to like, oh, my God, I love Lick It Up. And then as I listen to all these songs, I'm like, man, Creatures is so fucking good.
Yeah, yeah.
So what I'm just going to go by how many songs I picked. Ooh, so okay. Last, and I'm kind of a little disappointed. So at number 3 is going to be Lick It Up. And then I'm tied. So I think I'm going to go Animalize 2, Creatures 1.
Lick It Up, Animalize, Creatures, and the other one. Lick It Up, there's not a bad song on it.
Right.
I don't hit skip ever.
But Animalize before Creatures because...
Well, it's...
Burn, Bitch, Burn and all them.
Good song. I'm into the Burn, Bitch, Burn again. You know what I mean? And it was... it's just the...
it just sounds...
We're talking about what's the last song on it? Animalize...
Well, the City
Sleeps. I've Had Enough.
Murder High Heels.
That's the only one that I'll skip on there. It's just, I don't know. That's the way. Animalize is definitely second. It was the first tour that I saw, so it's got to come in second. But there's no bad song on Lick It Up.
Okay,
I'm not skipping anything, Steven.
Not skipping. No skippers.
No skippers.
I think I would skip Lonely is the Hunter. I think that'd be my only skipper.
Yeah, that's a skipper, too.
That's a kind of a snoozer.
Gene has skippers on there.
I don't know about skippers, but the skipper, for sure. For
on Animalize.
On Animalize.
He's got two.
His headspace was elsewhere.
He was thinking
Hollywood. For me, I'm going to go. I got to go lick it up first. Then I'm going creatures by a hair. The only one that is not making it, number two, is Lonely as the Hunter. Like, I will take Murder in High Heels. I like While the City Sleeps. I don't mind them songs. I don't think they suck.
They're just okay. But
Lonely as the Hunter
they're not.
Is a snoozer. But, like, Burn, Bitch, Burn, like that. Da, 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 that is one of the heaviest fucking riffs the KISS has.
So what was the order?
I did Lick It Up, Creatures, Animalize.
He did my list.
I did. Simpatico. Right. Simpatico. All right, so.
What about Dylan?
Yeah, did you want to ask?
I'm going to say, so Dylan's going to go last. So Dylan's going to go last, and then
go ahead. Then he's going to talk.
I'm looking at this list, and I'm feeling really bad for Animalize. So I'm going to go Animalize number one. I'm going to go Lick It Up two, and I'm going to go Creatures three. Although I like all these albums, the songs I like on these albums I really like. There's only a few that I'm not a huge fan of, most of them are just like I'm not as familiar with them. Is probably why I would rank Creatures lower than some of the other ones. But I like this era of KISS. It's a very underrated era in my mind, for sure.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Does anybody know why? I guess they changed the track listing on Creatures. They changed Saint and Sinner and Killer, I think. I think Killer, when it first came out, Killer was the second song. And then now it's Saint and Sinner.
It was originally Saint and Sinner.
Right?
Then they flipped it. And they changed the album cover. They took their makeup off. They released a different version of it.
Yeah, how about that one with Bruce on him? Like, why? And they changed, like, Gene's ass on the back.
And they changed the mix on it, too. They brought the drums down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you like that version better?
No. No, but I'm saying on the... They changed the... Does anybody know why they changed that?
But you know how you said you don't like the drums that loud because it distracts, like, maybe from Ace being there?
It does.
So you might like that version better.
No, well, if you listen to the version of I Love It Loud on... what the hell? They put it on one of the compilation albums after that.
Smashes, Rushes, and Apparition?
Smashes, yeah.
Oh, it's neutered. It's terrible.
It's
terrible.
It is. I'm not saying...
You don't have the loud drums.
Right. I don't... It distracts, but you sure as fuck miss it when it's not there.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
So you don't think the drums are too loud for Creatures?
No, it's just they're a little distracting for me. Okay. I like them. I love them.
But you don't like it. Okay.
But it's such a swing in sound.
Right. Mm-hmm. But even compared to the other version...
Right, yeah, like listen to I Love It Loud terrible. On Smashes, Thrashes, yeah. I'm like, what the fuck is, like, it's right. just so
It's electronic.
Dead.
It's like mono and stereo.
And it doesn't
fade
back. Yeah. It doesn't fade back in either.
Yeah, so I was just wondering if anybody knew why they changed that track listing. If anybody out there knows why they changed that track listing, let me know. It's just weird that's changed.
I know why.
Why?
Because people like you are going to buy it again.
I'm not going to buy it again
just
because of song
track.
People will. Oh, yeah. Absolutely, people will.
Right. It's a variant.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. It's an anomaly. Like the new Love Gun has got a little ink spot on one of the girls' heads, and they're calling it like the horn version now or something like that.
Kind of like Rock and Roll Over with the Teardrop. Yeah.
That one I had to get.
It's a variant.
That one I had to
it's
get.
It's a variant. Yeah, you got to have it.
I didn't get it.
But I'm not gonna go look for the horn version of the new KISS one.
And some of the labels, the inside labels, they have blue spots on them, too.
Yeah.
I saw that as well.
Yeah. And on the... And on the Unmasked, too, I think.
I missed the boat on the Unmasked. And the Dress to Kill.
Yeah.
Bummer.
The reissue.
What if one of the, they had the blood in the pressing of the...
The blood in the splatter. Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Pull
like the Marvel comic.
Yeah, sure.
They should do like a white and red splatter. That'd be cool.
Yeah. Well, they haven't done Live 2 yet. Maybe a reissue of Alive 2 is coming out. Maybe that's the big announcement.
The big announcement.
Maybe that's the big announcement.
Tomorrow at noon.
This is major news.
It might be.
Major news.
I don't know.
Major news.
I hope it. I hope it has the wow factor.
Yeah, I don't think they'd have a countdown clock for Alive 2.
I mean, they don't have a lot going on.
There's got to be something.
It'd be real easy to just stir up some
It might be a streaming show.
That'd be cool.
That'd be cool, but is that a major announcement?
Yeah.
Is it?
For them it is.
Yeah, maybe.
It's going to be streaming unplugged.
They're just going to play
major enough, though.
Rock and roll all night.
What the hell, a countdown clock?
Yeah, I just hope they didn't overhype this, whatever it is.
I don't know.
By the time you guys listen to this, we could be right or we could be wrong. Or somewhere in between.
I can guarantee you the reality is not going to meet the expectation. I can almost guarantee it.
99.9% correct.
Probably not. Probably not. I hope so.
You just can't expect too much and you'll be fine.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, think it's going to be a new DVD, and then it could be something better than that. You'd be like, "Oh, that's awesome!" Like
that. I'd like to see Kissology 4.
Yes, I would too.
Well, that's a possibility.
They're not doing a countdown for that.
No,
I don't think so.
This is some type of live show performance.
I think it's the new date for their last show. That's what I think.
It could be
2022.
Right.
2053.
Because they're probably, they may not even play a show before that date that it was like, what, June or July 21st or something like of 2021.
Yeah.
They may not even have played a show by then. So that date's going to be gone. Plus, Kiss Cruise is scheduled for after that. Which, we have our cabin is right here. Rob, Scott, Chris and myself.
Now we just need a cabin.
We just need a cabin.
We were close.
We're
on the edge.
We'll get one. We'll get one. I think so.
We're on the wait list.
Yeah. So we'll get one.
They released the theme nights today. Did you see that?
I saw that, but my email wasn't loaded.
Halloween night, pajama night.
80s night.
Your favorite song night or something like your favorite song.
How can I dress like Got Love for Sale?
Put a for sale sign on your naked.
Put dollar signs on my nipples.
Nice. I'm gonna say,
wife is not gonna let you leave the house.
No, that would be. No one wants to see that. I don't even want to see that. All right, so hopefully we had some entertaining albums here. It'd be cool if you guys out there, let us know what you guys would pick. Give us 11 songs or give us 10 songs or whatever. What would you guys pick from Killers, Creatures, Lick It Up, Animalize? Three very different sounding albums, four guitar players at least on these albums.
Oh, and more.
You know, because like what they say, Ace didn't play at all on Creatures, right?
No.
Bob Kulick played on Killers. Lick It Up. Rick Derringer, Vinnie Vincent, there was another
Steve Ferris from Mr. Big.
Yeah. And Bruce and Mark. Well, Mark St. John played the most of Animalize.
What song did Bruce play on?
He played on While the City Sleeps, right?
I believe he also played on Murder in High Heels.
Murder in High Heels. Yeah.
So the best song in the album.
Bruce was, you know, in the mix there too. So you have like really five or six guitar players between like the three albums.
You're not mentioning Paul Stanley.
Lead guitar players.
Lead guitar players.
Yes.
I just want to clarify.
They brought in some guests.
Mitch Weissman also did guitar overdubs, according to Wikipedia.
There was a lot of people on those albums.
Yeah, they were. I think they were so lost at that period.
Yep.
Like especially like Creatures, Killers, like
yeah.
Paul wanted to take the makeup off, I guess. Gene was against it.
Yep.
And if you watch videos of Kiss in the early 80s up until like Hot in the Shade, Revengeous, Gene was like, didn't know what the fuck to do with himself on stage.
Yep.
Like with the, like he just seemed so awkward.
Yeah.
You know? He wasn't clean.
You know, yeah. Clean.
Especially Lick It Up live. He just didn't, on stage, he didn't know what to do.
Yeah.
He didn't know what to do.
Because that was like right out of the makeup.
Yeah. And he's sticking his tongue out and just like doing.
And their manager told him, don't do that. No one wants to see that. If you have the makeup on, yes. But no one wants to see you stick out your tongue with no makeup on.
Right. But then he brought it back. He stopped for a little while and then he brought it right back.
Yeah.
Because they're like, yeah.
He couldn't help himself. Because, I mean, playing them songs, he probably was. That's a physical habit, too.
It is. Yeah. He's so used to it.
You know what I mean? So.
But he was doing that persona without the makeup and he didn't realize it. You know, for 10 years they did it, so.
And supposedly, if you believe legend or whatever, he supposedly did the blood on the first Lick It Up show, but no one can confirm or deny that.
No. I'm glad he kept doing blowing the fire, though.
Fire was always cool.
He kept that. Fire was always cool. So that was awesome to see that, too. So.
Sure. Yeah, so. But, I mean, go out and watch Animalize Live Uncensored. That should have been KISS Live 3.
Yeah.
That should have been KISS Live 3 or done something from Hot in the Shade.
Right.
Something with Eric Carr. Eric Carr should have been on KISS Alive 3, whatever it was.
Yeah. And then KISS Alive 4 could have been with Bruce and, you know.
Right. From the Revenge Tour and all that shit. Yeah. So, absolutely. All right, guys. So, we'll go around the table. We'll say our final thoughts and words, and we'll wrap up. Mr. Granza.
Good night.
Man, a few words.
I had fun with you fellas today. Good time. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Steve, and guys, thanks for having me on. A great time, good list, good conversation. Like I said, you know, these albums are just, they're great. KISS at their heaviest, and I think, you know, kind of through this period and just a great underrated period of the band's history, and great live shows, too. Great memories.
Yeah, definitely you hit it. This is their heaviest, right here, these three albums. This is KISS at their heaviest. So many people involved, you know, they're all wound up. They don't know what to do, take it off, leave it on. They're so crazy, but a turning point for these guys, and I think they really hit it on the head. I really liked the way, the avenue they went down, the way they did the shredding, they kind of try to keep with the time, but not really. They kind of turned it a little bit, had their own little sprinkle of KISS in there. But a great list from everyone here. Great conversation, great band. You know, I love when the KISS clan gets together here, and a very good episode. Love it.
Yeah, thanks for coming on, guys. Always a pleasure to have you on. I really like these albums. I like the albums that everybody made. I think that a lot of good songs to pick from, and nobody really picked any egregious clunkers, I don't think. I enjoyed everybody's list personally, and it was a really good time. And you can listen to a lot of the songs that we talked about tonight on our Spotify playlist of the week, and that it's going to be linked in the episode below. So check it out. Let us know what some of your favorite tracks are from these three albums and four-song selection from a greatest hits situation. If you even want to pick any songs from there, you don't have to. I didn't.
I didn't either.
You should have.
I didn't want to. Too late.
It was fun. It was a lot of fun tonight. It was very difficult to pick these songs because they're like three fantastic albums. So, I mean, we all had a great time. It was all tough for all of us, wasn't it? Picking what songs we're going to do. And the next three albums are going to be even tougher because that's, you know, it's... Then they didn't know what direction they were going in. It was...
But they may not be next, though.
Oh, okay. So, but anyway, these three...
The next three chronologically.
Right. These three albums, they were trying to get out of that hole that they dug, and they were coming back, and I like how you sprinkled a little KISS in there. Mm-hmm. It was a good... Yeah, good... But it was fun. It was a good night. It was, you know, I enjoyed myself talking about these albums, bringing up a lot of memories.
Yeah, always a good time, guys. Thanks for coming and being our KISS crew. It's always a blast when you guys come. And I like the ball busting that goes on because, you know, we got the Paul guy, the Gene guy, that they clash. And
Christopher.
BB had to grind some gears there for Rob tonight, which is good.
Poor Ace.
Of course, really. Poor Ace. And BB always wears his Vinnie Vincent shirt when we do this shit together. Sorry BC had to miss this one, so hopefully we can get him on the next one. And like Dylan said, you can check out the songs on the Spotify playlist. And let us know out there, you guys, what album you guys would make out there from these three albums and the four songs from Killers. It was tough. It really was. I was like, I had these on a playlist. I played them in a row. I shuffle played them, and it was still tough. I had all kinds of notes and shit written everywhere, and then I'd have it done, and I'm like, no, you know what? I got to put this one in there. So it's very difficult to do. So we appreciate you guys hanging with us, and we love talking KISS, and hope you guys enjoyed the our gem song, the song from Thunder, which I thought was kick-ass. So let us know if you guys like that too. And thanks for hanging with us. And you can give us, we'd appreciate a good, if you could do a 5-star review on Apple Music or iTunes and Podchaser, it would be fantastic. And we'll read it out. And we love the interaction with you guys out there. You know, post to us on Facebook. You can friend us on Facebook, and you can direct message us if you want, if you got something you want to say, or if you have a topic you want us to talk about, or maybe we could even get you on the show. So thanks for listening, everybody. We appreciate it. We love you guys. Thanks for hanging with us, and take care of yourselves and each other. Do your social distancing, wear your masks, you know, just everybody be cool. Don't be a dick about stuff. Wash your hands, you filthy animals. And we'll see you next time, guys, and there definitely will be a next time.